Right, people, we have a Swan DVR, which is a four-channel DVR recording system. Basically, the symptom of this device is that when you go into the option screen and select a device, the hard drive status is good. But unfortunately, it sort of stops recording randomly, and sometimes the recording stops altogether. So I believe I know what the problem is with it. So I'm going to have a go through a quick troubleshooting process, basically see if I can fix the unit. I've already undone a couple of screws here, and I'm just going to carry on doing the rest. I believe it's a capacitor that's actually gone on it, but until I don't open the unit, I'm not 100% adamant. Okay, so that's the inside of the unit itself. First thing first is my concern was on this capacitor, and it doesn't seem like it's bloated, so I'm a bit anxious where the problem could lie. Okay, that can come. Can bubble off. So this, let's take everything off. Let's take this battery out. Okay. Let's get this out. Let's get this out. Okay now. Now let's take out the board. Okay. Right, here we go. That's the main PCB, so get rid of this for now. If I can find some space somewhere. Funny enough, the DVR sort of turns on, but it only sort of randomly does all the recording. What I'm going to do is, my guess is that I'm going to run an ESR test on this capacitor here. So let's get on with removing this thing. Please forgive me, it's an extractor fan, so I'm not going to be inhaling solder fumes. Go. Right, I think my metcal is
is. Right, there we go.
I don't know why it's doing what it's doing. It's all the fucking time. You know, it's. We're gonna do something. Yep, resetting, that's good. More like it. Right, so what we're expecting, this is a 1016 volt microfarad capacitor. So let's do a bit of a test on that. I'm using an Atlas ESR meter. Yes, our 70 plus. I'll get rid of this. Like that. There you go. This. Right, so that seems to be sort of reading fine. Yep, that's coming up with, I don't know if you can see it, but. Come on. Get rid of this bloody light. There you go, so that seems to be sort of reading fine. Hence, I'm still going to sort of swap it out for a new cap and see how I'll see. Just checking for any visual leakage from one of the capacitors. Can't actually see a BGA IC underneath this heatsink. And I pray to God that I don't need to sort of work on that. So the only downside is that I don't have a circuit diagram to troubleshoot this actually, so that can make things a little bit harder. But anyway, that's beside the point. Let's just find some capacitors and that. So what I'm after is a 1016 volt. Right, one other thing I'd like to do is check the voltage of this battery. That's fine. What was it? 1016 volt. Okay, so. Oh my god. I don't think I'll have any of it. 1016 volt. I've got 1500. Not 1000. 2200. Nope, that's not good. Right, I'm going to have a bit of a fun scattering through finding a 1016 volt capacitor, so let's have a bit of a. Nope, that's not good. Not good. Ah! There we go. 1000. Okay, got a couple of them here. Oh yes, I've got a handful of them here. So you can go back there. I wish I had a new one. I do actually have some new ones. It's a very bad idea to sort of use used capacitors. They're really completely utter waste of time. So what we're going to do is I have a 1,000 microfarad 16 volt. Okay. I'm going to test on this and make sure that the capacitor is okay. Okay, bang on, 1000 microfarad, 0.00 ESR. What ESR stands for, equivalent series resistance. This device sort of tests if there is a leakage on the capacitor. So it's quite a handy tool to have anyway. Just rerun the test and make sure that it's all good. Yep, that's fine. The one I've taken off, I'll just rerun the test on that. Okay, that's also seems to be fine, but I'm still going to swap this because I'm not happy. Okay, so put the fan back on. What did I do with the solder wire? Quite a bit of flux here. Quite a noisy extractor fan, that actually. It's very noisy, I should say. But at the same time, it's very good at doing what it does. Takes all the crap off. Off. Blah, 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 blah. Right, so hopefully, okay. Let's put this frigging thing back together. Okay. You know, funny enough, I'm gonna get a Hoover and clean this shit out of the fan. It's absolutely filthy.
everything on my right. It will get noisy now because of the fever, so please bear with me. Right, back on the case now. What am I gonna do now? Okay. Okay, we're happy with that. Battery goes back in. Funny enough, what I would like to do is just poke around the bottom so I think it's just to sort of satisfy myself that it's okay. It's never the coil, absolutely never the coil. Sort of, while I put things back together, I just want to check these capacitors actually. So what I'm going to do now is just compensated the probe, turn it on. Okay, and I'm going to poke around. Okay. Okay, let's look at some of these. Right, okay, that can bugger off. Right, let's check something else here. That's okay. And that's okay. Right, I'm going to put the bod back in there and run the DVR and see how it, what if it has resolved the problem.
that I initially had. But if I can get it back in its place without fucking up anything else. Okay. I'm not going to use the. Put this clip back on. Quite late, I'm tired. Connecting everything back in, no, in its own place. Okay, so just make sure that the screws are on. That's on. Capacitor is okay. Battery's on. That's on. That's attached. Okay. Fans free. Right, brutal truth. I'm sorry I can't show you this, but I have a recording system over there. Across the room over there, so I'm going to test it on that. And then see if that's done the trick. So that's as far as it gets, but most commonly it's this capacitor that's actually on here that gets messed up in relation to the problem what I've been having, no, one of my customers been having actually, I should say. So hopefully that should resolve the problem, but if not I'll get back to you, but 99.9% of the time is that's what fucks up actually. So thank you for watching.